What you're about to see now is an example of conversational AI that will have significant impact on how we communicate in the future. Unfortunately, at the same time, it'll also introduce even more challenges with deepfakes, identity theft, and potential fraud than we've ever seen before.
Hi, am I speaking to the real Lars Seier?
No, I'm not the real Lars Seier Christensen. I'm an AI-trained human digital twin to simulate his personality based on his experience and knowledge.
If Arsenal and FC Copenhagen were playing each other, who would you root for?
That would indeed be a tough choice, as both clubs hold a special place in my heart. However, I would probably lean towards FC Copenhagen, as I have a direct influence and investment in that club. It would be an exciting match, no doubt.
Try asking him a question in Chinese.
请问你去过中国吗?
是的，我去过中国，这是一个迷人的国家。 拥有悠久的历史和充满活力的经济，探索新的文化和经济总是很有趣，尤其是像中国这样有影响力的文化和经济。
What did he ask?
I asked him if he has been to China. He said yes, and he found it fascinating.
All right. I know that the real Lars doesn't speak Chinese. How did his digital twin do?
It was almost fluent, and it was very easy to understand.
You probably noticed that the person you saw on the screen wasn't actually me, but a digital version of me. Give it a few months and the real-time conversational AI technology will get so good that you won't be able to tell the difference. And that's where Concordium's Web3 ID with zero knowledge proofs and verifiable credentials comes into play. For that reason, I have recently invested in an AI project in Bangkok focused on developing digital human twins and authenticating them using Concordium's Web3 ID. Let me share a little report from my visit to Bangkok. I spent most of the day here at Lion Brain in Bangkok, a city that you might recognize from the beautiful skyline behind me. Lion Brain is my latest investment and represents a particularly interesting use case for Concordium with enormous potential. For some time now, I've been examining the AI / blockchain space to explore opportunities for Concordium that can generate exponential growth and traction. I got introduced to Anders Hasler, who, in addition to being the research leader at the AI Institute at Thailand's largest university, Chulalongkorn, also runs a commercial AI development company, Lion Brain. Anders and his team here at Lion Brain have developed a platform called Friar, designed for generating human digital twins. This platform allows users to create, to train, and optimize digital replicas of a living or even a deceased person. By incorporating voice and face cloning, the digital twins become real-time conversational avatars of potentially any human being. Just imagine not having to attend to all your meetings yourself, but instead sending your human digital twin, who asks all the right questions, and forwards you a brief summary of the decisions made afterwards, or taking the initial interviews when you're hiring new people, or discussing metaphysics with Aristotle, or even being able to talk to your deceased loved ones. The possibilities are endless, but they also present some challenges that Concordium is uniquely positioned to solve. Deepfakes, fraud, and not least digital identity theft will take on a whole new dimension when you can communicate with these human digital twins in real time. Because if I can make a digital copy of myself that you can talk to, anyone else with access to the right tools could also make a copy of me. Now, I don't want to see myself giving investment advice for scams or luring people into sending money to obscure crypto accounts, and I'm sure neither would you. And you definitely want to know who you're talking to or to be able to verify who's behind the avatar. At the same time, most regulators are working on legislation and directives regarding AI. The latest EU regulation, the so-called EU AI Act, along with many national reports, consistently highlights the theme of responsibility. The United Nations recently drafted an AI resolution calling for effective measures that promote innovation for the internationally interoperable identification. Everyone is talking about AI responsibility and identification, yet no one has presented a sustainable solution. So why don't I ask my digital twin if he has any ideas? Lars, what would it take to solve this?
Such a solution would need to fulfill all critical requirements, including authentication, verification, accountability, and notably privacy.
Does Concordium offer this solution?
Certainly. Concordium's Web3 ID with zero-knowledge proof capability ticks all these boxes and is ready to solve one of the major challenges AI will face in the near future.
See? I knew it. Now here is how it actually works.
My name is Nibras, and I am the CTO and CPO of Concordium. Concordium, as its essence, is a layer one blockchain where identity is embedded in the protocol level. What that means is that before anyone does a transaction, they have to be identified. Because of this, we can also leverage the power of zero knowledge proofs, which is really a technology that can ask for information without giving all of your data. An example of this is, I enter a website where the website, in this case a casino, would ask me, are you over or under 18? Instead of me giving the website all of my data for them to store, we can leverage zero knowledge proofs and the identity of Concordium to give back, yes, I am over 18 and I can enter the room. What we introduce with Web3 ID at Concordium is that we expand beyond the identity framework. With Web3 ID, we actually allow others to become issuers of credentials. What that means is that employers can issue a certificate that you actually work for them, and universities can also issue diplomas, and even healthcare providers can issue your records when you go to the doctors. On the other hand, they can also ask you for consent to get access of previous visited healthcares. It really is very flexible, where you, in a very self-serving manner, own your data without compromising it to other companies. A credential really is just an alternative to a soul-bound token, where the token is on-chain in a smart contract, and the credential itself is off-chain in a true self-serving manner. So, how does this all then relate to AI, and how can Concordium take a part of that? With Web3 ID, we can actually use this to make sure that when you interact with a digital twin in an AI model, you for a fact know that someone is behind this. Let me explain more. Imagine Lars' digital twin. Lars, behind that, can actually give consent that, yes, my digital twin is allowed to enter this meeting or wherever meetings he wants the digital twin to be. So when he enters the streaming service and that meeting, the streaming service knows that behind this AI model is actually a person who's giving consent. And therefore, we know that we can have the AI accountability that we're after. On the other hand, I, as a Nibras entering this meeting room, might also want to know, hey, I'm interacting with an AI model here. How can I make sure that this is not deep fake, an actual person such as Lars is behind this AI model? I can then ask the system, can you please verify that there is a person that has been ID'd behind this model? And what I can get back using zero knowledge proof that we just explained is, yes, a person has actually been identified. I think the future is very exciting, but I also think Concordium has a really big play here when it comes to AI verification and accountability.
By integrating Concordium's Web3 ID with our newest use case, Lionbrain's AI platform Friar, you unlock a unique solution that will be crucial for most conversational AI projects in the future. This integration also offers substantial potential for ID verified users on Concordium's blockchain. Please join Concordium for a safer tomorrow.
If you're interested in exploring Concordium's Web3 ID and verifiable credentials, additional information is available at concordium.ai. For those eager to test Lionbrain's AI platform and create your own human digital twin, join the waiting list at friar.ai.